Hello everyone, this is Ashok Tekate. In this video, I have tried to show you a different way of practicing the handwriting of English alphabet. We write in Italic style of handwriting, which is very neat, legible, clear and beautiful. Before making our children to practice the letters of the alphabet, we need to give them enough exposure in practicing different strokes which appear in different letters of the alphabet. Once they are familiarized and feel easy with these strokes, they can easily write the letters of the alphabet. English handwriting is stroke based. Let us know about these strokes first. Let our students practice them well. Here, I am trying to introduce a new way of teaching handwriting. Depending on the shapes and movements in each letter, we can categorize all 26 letters into three categories. In each separate category, shapes and movements of all the letters are almost alike or similar, and one letter leads to another letter. In order to get a new letter, they need to make a small change to the previous letter or need to add a little to the previous letter. In this way, they can easily move from one letter to another letter while writing, and with this they feel it very easy to write all 26 letters with right shape and size. The writing process becomes enjoyable for them. Let's practice the first set of 11 letters. All lowercase letters are slightly slanted to the right side. They have oval shapes instead of round shape. They have slanted lines and a triangle. Let's start with the letter A. If we continue the letter A, it leads to letter D. Instead of moving up, if we come down, it becomes the letter G. If we bring a small change to the letter G, it becomes Q. Let's come to the letter A again. It carries one more letter already in it, that is C. If we start at the middle point of two lines, it becomes E. If you join the C, it becomes O. Next is S. Let's come back to the letter A again. It already carries one more letter in it, U. If we go downwards, it becomes Y. This Y already has one more letter in it, that is J. This is first set of 11 letters with the similar shapes and movements. Let us know about the second set. We start with the letter L. If we put a cross to the letter L, it becomes T. If we start and end with a bend using all four lines, it becomes F. Now, here we use only middle two lines. This is I. If we bring a small change to the letter I, it becomes R. If we continue the letter R, it becomes N. If we add to the letter N, it becomes M. If we start from the first line, the letter N becomes H. If we continue this H, it becomes B. If we start from the second line with the same shape and touch the bottom line, it becomes P. While writing H, if we make a small change, it becomes K. This is the second set of 11 letters. The next four letters are formed by using a small line in different directions. The first letter is V. The next letter is W. Now it's X. And the last letter is Z. Now it's time to practice the letters in uppercase style. All uppercase letters are classified into three categories according to the number of strokes. We have one stroke, two stroke, three stroke letters. The first one stroke letter is C. The next letter is G. We use all four lines to write it. Next, here comes I, J, L. It looks like two stroke letter, but it is one stroke. Now it is O, S, U, V. Look at here, only one stroke we use to write the letter V. And in the same way, the next letter is W and Z. This is a set of 11 letters of one stroke. Now it is two stroke letters. The first two stroke letter is B, D, K, M. N, P, Q. R, T, X, and Y. This is another set of 11 letters here. The last set of letters are three stroke letters. The first three stroke letter is A, E, F, and the last letter is H. In this way, we practice italic style of handwriting in lowercase and uppercase letters. Thank you.